In 2007, Dutch extreme athlete Wim Hof, also known as the Iceman, climbed 7,468 meters of Mount Everest in nothing but shorts and open-toed sandals. According to Hof, it was quite easy. He uses a breathing technique called the Wim Hof Method. It's taught to dedicated pupils the world over. Legions of his acolytes are now swimming in icy lakes and hiking through the tundra in little more than shorts and shoes. What if you found yourself naked in a freezing place like the Arctic? Aside from the Wim Hof Method, what would it take to survive? We'll find out on today's chilling challenge. This is Your Body On, naked in the Arctic for 1 month. The Arctic is one of the harshest ecosystems on the planet, with temperatures dipping as low as minus 68 degrees Celsius. Normally, people enter this region wearing heavy winter gear, but we're stripping you of all that. You're going to be completely naked in the Arctic. How long do you think you could survive? Luckily, the average temperature in the Arctic during the summertime is 0 degrees Celsius. So let's assume you'll be doing this challenge during the summer. But the temperatures will fluctuate. Now, let's ditch those clothes and see how you fare. It's 0 degrees Celsius. Your first order of business is to employ the Wim Hof breathing technique. Take 30 quick breaths, then exhale and keep your lungs empty as long as you can. Next, take one sharp inhale and hold it for 10 to 15 seconds. Repeat this cycle 3 or 4 times. Combined with meditation, this method of breathing suggests that you can withstand frigid temperatures by getting your body to switch from burning carbohydrates to burning fats. If practiced correctly, the Wim Hof method might help you survive in these colder temperatures. For now. Thanks to the Wim Hof method, you've made it through day one. Yesterday was a balmy 0 degrees Celsius. Today is a bitter minus 18 degrees Celsius. It may feel much harsher than yesterday, but this is tame compared to a winter month in the Arctic. Under these conditions, your exposed skin is now susceptible to frostbite, which can occur in just 30 minutes. Frostbite happens in 3 stages. Stage 1. Frostnip is a mild skin irritation causing redness and coldness, followed by numbness. Stage 2. Superficial frostbite will make your skin feel warm. A fluid-filled blister may form around 24 to 36 hours after the warming sensation begins. Stage 3. Deep frostbite will cause you to experience numbness. Your joints or muscles may no longer work, and eventually the area will harden and turn black as the tissue dies. Frostbite usually affects the fingers, toes, lips, nose, and ears, but since you're naked, who knows what else could be damaged? If you don't find clothes and shelter fast, you likely won't survive another day. The temperature has remained at minus 18 degrees Celsius, but a 24 kilometer per hour wind has picked up, making it feel more like minus 28 degrees Celsius.
It's so cold that I saw a group of chickens walk into KFC to warm up.
Somehow, you've made it this far. You've already lost some of your fingers and toes to frostbite, and to prevent losing more, you'll have to act quickly. You could build a shelter out of snow that will help shield you from some of the wind, or depending where you are, you could find a cave to hide in. There is wildlife that lives in the Arctic Circle, like polar bears, Arctic foxes, walruses, and seals. You could potentially hunt these animals and use their hides as clothes.
Oh, hell no!
But you'll want to avoid going in water at all costs. If the water temperature is 0.2 degrees Celsius or colder, you'll not survive more than 15 to 45 minutes. You'll undergo shock within the first 2 minutes and functional disability within 30 minutes. And that's with clothing. That leaves you with polar bears and Arctic foxes. You likely won't have the energy to win a fight against a polar bear, or any other creature for that matter, without clothes and in freezing conditions. But let's say you did somehow kill a polar bear with your bare hands. One option would be tearing it open and climbing inside to use its body heat for warmth. Be careful though, because the dead animal could attract other predators and you'd eventually have to crawl out of it, covered in blood and fluids. Then you would lose body heat even faster. At most, this tactic might keep you alive for a few hours. Phew, luckily for you, the temperature went back up to 0 degrees Celsius. The Wim Hof Method and your survival instincts kept you alive for a whole week.
Merry Christmas to you!
You've managed to build a snow shelter and kill a polar bear, surviving on its meat and using its fur as a blanket, but you're in terrible shape. Heavy breathing can take a toll on your lungs in polar weather, so you've been suffering from violent coughing fits. You've lost a significant amount of body fat, making you feel even colder. You're malnourished, weak, and exhausted. On top of all that, you can't stop shivering, and you're experiencing memory loss, incoherence, and slurred speech. Not that you have anyone to talk to anyway. These are the symptoms of hypothermia, which happens when your body's core temperature dips below 35 degrees Celsius.
It's actually so cold!
Factors like body fat and age can affect how long hypothermia takes to set in, but after a week in the Arctic, it's taken hold of you. By this point, you're probably dead.
No, it's probably this way.
Even with the makeshift igloo and polar bear fur, if you were completely naked in the Arctic for an entire month, you'd spend at most a few days alive and the rest of the month frozen stiff. While you can die from frostbite, it's exceptionally rare and usually only occurs from complications such as gangrene and infection. It's the hypothermia that got you. While you can't survive there naked for a month, you can certainly survive with the proper preparation.
You are the owner of your own brain.
About 4 million people live in the Arctic region, many of them members of indigenous groups that have thrived there for millennia. A safer choice would be exploring the Arctic while clothed in heavy winter attire with appropriate camping gear, like a sub-zero sleeping bag and tent. Or better yet, just stay inside, preferably in a warm, cozy cabin. Speaking of warm, why don't we try a little less freezing challenge? Like eating spicy foods. Think you're up for it? Well, we'll see what that challenge brings on the next episode of Your Body On.